Welcome to the 2020 MEBW Hall of Fame ceremony. I've got people here. I see Mark Jindrak in the crowd. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. That's Joe Erebus. Doesn't even have shoes on. Seeing him not wearing shoes, Tommy Gunn is barefoot. At least you got the bow tie on. Not that we can see it.
Yeah, no.
Adam's making a third time attire at Hall of Fame. Owen O'Ryan is here. Jack Delta looks like an E3 presenter. Me and Matt Thunder are matching, so I can't say anything bad. Blake Viper is here physically. And Austin Apex is here, but there's no one to lose to, so I don't know why. Unfortunately, Raylo and Gingy couldn't attend. They're too busy ghost riding the whip. So yeah, it's time to get this show on the road, and I'm going to start off with announcing the first match of the year, excepting for the first match of the year, which is Matt Thunder and Maximus Roman at The Great War. Matt Thunder.
Yeah. I think I'd be standing really.
Oh, come on. Oh. What do you think this is?
I'm going to be standing all night,
shitty
though.
Frames. You know, sir?
Shit on the frames.
Stand up here with me.
Okay.
Stand up to the camera. Thank you. Roll Maximus Roman.
Hey, MEBW fans, Maximus Roman here, and I'd like to thank MEBW, the roster, the CEO, Cody Powers, the management, everybody that worked for this Hall of Fame. You're doing a great job, and I'm enjoying watching it from Jersey. Now, I know it's sad that I couldn't be a part of Mania this year, but hey, real life happened, COVID happened, and I couldn't make it out there. So, I'm sorry for that, but you're welcome for putting on one of the greatest matches in Backyard Wrestling, Maximus Roman versus Matt Thunder. That sounded a little bit selfish, but I want to thank everybody involved in the making. Zach, I want to thank you, and thank you for putting that match in the Hall of Fame.
Well, Maximus Roman just spoke about this match. We have spoken about this match so many times. It's in the EBW Hall of Fame, too. Yeah, there's not much more to say anymore.
Yeah,
Matt. Thanks, sir.
All right, next up, presenting attire of the year, I have Jack Delta.
It's funny because as soon as I knew I got picked for this award, I was like, man,
dude, you
I
have
know.
The best attire on. Yeah.
I knew that I wasn't going to be getting it. But the nominees are Chris Storm at Backyard Mania 3, the Joker. Matt Thunder, 2020 attire. Raylo Lantana, Kobe in Memoriam. Matt Thunder's Into the Fire attire.
Alright.
Joe Erebus and Cody Powers as the Doomslayer.
The Doomslayer.
And Maximus Roman, Living in America attire.
Oh yeah.
And the winner is Thunder again.
Oh, God! Damn!
Wow.
Hold the back!
It's not happening this year.
Who bought these?
You?
CVS! So, Dollar Tree!
Yeah, that was a cool outfit.
And
wait, I don't know.
Way to keep the ceremony going.
Three, two. So up next to present promo of the year, we have Joe Erebus, take two.
Yeah. I'm making the show.
Presenting this promo? Because I can't get a promo. That's why you said take two. So, the nominees are...
Speak up.
Jack Delta...
What?
Jack Delta told me a story Kind of salt. You got Matt Thunder and Maximus Roman. You got the regime is rich and laughs at powers and error, bitch.
I wrote it like that. He read it. Look.
This is staying in.
Tommy Gunn is now the owner, and Tommy Gunn excavates Jack Delta. Tommy Gunn.
Tommy Gunn is presenting the award.
Yeah, I'm accepting the award.
The award.
Oh yeah.
We got there.
Oh yeah.
Oh, shock and awe, brother. All right.
Hold the back.
All right. I feel you can. I'm not gonna pose with you. That's Zach. Give me.
We're too big.
All right. Well, it's my job to extend this show out a little bit. No, I'm just kidding.
I did it.
So I'm winning this award for the absolute wildfire I started about Jack Delta and his family. I would like to take this opportunity to apologize to his currently estranged family members who did not take too kindly to the things that I said. I've been blocked on Twitter, and I just want you to know that it's just doing my job, all right? Anyway, yeah, I'm going to keep cutting great promos, and they're going to continuously be 7 minutes, and our editors will have to deal with them. Thank you.
Chad, forget his phone. Chad, forget his phone.
Yeah, Chad!
Woo! We got Kashad, Chad.
Tommy Gunn is going to be coming right back up. You just sat down. You got to come
back
up.
Oh, I forgot.
Because it's time to present a very special award for this year that you will do.
Yeah. Okay, so when I was thinking about this before my shower earlier, I thought, well, I'll just go from one thing to another, but I forgot because Chad. So before we become backyard wrestlers, before we even think about doing it, we're fans, right? And before we go on the journey that we're all sharing together, all we want to see is storytelling that tugs at our emotions, matches that make us feel things. And because of that, this year, we had an incredible story, and there's going to be a special award for that story. Back at No Escape 2019, there's a fatal four-way elimination match for the world championship, and it came down to Jack Delta and Tyler Adams. And right as Jack Delta was about to capture glory, our pal Joe Dean, the referee, kicked him in the dick.
Jobber Joe Dean.
Tyler Adams became the world champion for a record fourth time. Joe Dean became Owen O'Ryan, and then Tommy Gunn, which is me, came out and clocked you in the face.
Yes, he did.
3 days later, Matt Thunder joined, and we were the regime. Jack Delta went on his own tear as we started to run roughshod on the entire company. And he eventually completed the first undefeated Mayhem tournament, and he won. And after some turmoil between Thunder and Adams and Joe Dean not winning any matches, we arrived at House of Hardcore, where you two put on one of the best spectacles and the greatest moments in the history of our company, where Jack Delta finally captured the world championship. And then a month later, at Last Call, you followed that with, in my opinion, the best stipulation match in the history of backyard wrestling, bar none. So for that, we are presenting the both of you with an award for excellence in storytelling for that 5-month feud, and additionally, both of the matches I just mentioned, the main event of House of Hardcore and of Last Call, they're both in the Hall of Fame as well. So Delta, you're gonna come up and accept, and I have three things.
Jesus.
And you can, yeah, have fun.
Can't hold the best. Okay, we'll
there's three.
There's three.
You gotta say what they know.
I just want to say that the reason those stories were so good was because there's a different meaning behind it. beyond just wrestling. And Tyler Adams is one of the first people and probably my first rival in MEBW that I actually consider a person who helped elevate my career and get me to where I needed to be today. And those two matches in particular are some of the best that this company has to offer. And
we are going to be presenting something a little different this year. MEBW would be nothing without the fans, so we went through and meticulously counted from Backyard Mania 3 to Revolution every single comment into a folder and saw who commented the most.
We did that.
That took a while. And
Several days.
And
it's just the people with full totals.
Well, gotcha. I have to do scrolls, but I'll do it anyways. Why is it so small? Well, there we go. So, we have, of course, Tom Akin.
Yeah.
Biggle, of course. I expected that. John Morgan, of course. Yes. I expected that. Boosted Media.
Boosted.
Apache King, of course. Okay. Brendan K, of course.
Viper.
Kyle T. Jay Kaman. Ryler James. Crazy L, of course. And finally, Mark B. So, thank all of you for commenting so much. That was so many damn comments. I couldn't keep going. I had to stop eventually.
Literally probably like 1,000 over the entire span.
At least. No, I'm not taking the glasses off. Shut the fuck up, Joe Erebus. Coming up next. To present the fourth Hall of Fame match, Owen O'Ryan.
Oh yeah, yeah. Owen. Train wreck Owen, oh yeah.
I'm introducing the fourth match.
Yeah.
You guys ready?
Yeah.
You ready?
Yeah. Do it, man.
You sure?
Okay. Yeah.
The fourth match. Tyler Adams and Matt Thunder. January 1st.
2020. Yeah, you're up.
See, I don't do these things. I don't win awards, so. Or yeah. Matches.
Yeah, I feel you on that one.
Except for you. I'm beating you.
Yeah, I don't think so, buddy.
So, January 1st.
Took my seat.
Okay, then you gotta hold this now.
Fuck up.
Anyways, thank you for presenting me with that, and also thank you for being there for this match, because as great of a match as it was, the tension needed to kick off with something, and it literally kicked off your face. So, thank you for that, because as soon as I saw you get kicked in the face, I was a little bit heated, and I was like, all right, this is now going to be a match. So, from something that I went into anticipating no match and just a laydown, to something that escalated much further, thank you for that.
And we beat him up with chairs after.
Yeah!
Woo! Yeah. Yeah. We love
the
assault.
The
right.
Question
that's
to the day
named one of our
was
shows
Matt
after.
Thunder's injury real?
No, that was Patreon exclusive questions. They're not allowed to be on the product. Owen O'Ryan, don't kick me again or I'll fucking murder your family. All right, next up, we have a category returning from last year, and that is Most Improved. Now, this go-around, Most Improved was voted on by the booking team, and there were two really clear options.
And it's not going to be given to a bum. So, go on.
Call back to last year. You're fired. But aside from that, there's two people that we really had to narrow it down to and go back and forth on, and after a while, we figured that there was one person that it really could go to this year, and that is Joe Erebus.
All right, now it's time to do a series. We'll try this out for once and we'll see how it goes.
Be sure to hold it back.
Okay. In all honesty, though, I appreciate every single person in this room right now. I don't know where I would be without every single person in here. I don't know where I would be in the world today. And I'm glad I met all of you. For real, thank all of you guys.
Good job, Chad.
So, up next is another new award for this year, and that is Funniest Off-Script Moment to present the nominees.
Blake Viper.
Oh, wow.
Alright. Funniest off-script moment. These are the nominees. Onslaught, CEO goes all general tarples mid-match.
Wait, do it. Just so people understand.
Use that in big doo-doo, Jaja!
Joe Erebus, bad entrances montage.
Just a montage of like six really bad, like he eats shit.
Erebus is down. Erebus is down. Erebus is down. Erebus is down.
We're watching that.
The resume discusses Mario character.
I remember that.
Is that not allowed to say that?
No, it's good. That's okay. Good.
That's alright. It's all fake. In Onslaught, Cody Powers gets beat by the resume.
That was funny.
The winner goes to... The regime discusses Mario characters.
Listen here, Bowser, Peach, and Toad. You three need to chill the fuck out.
Well, Matt Thunder is in the chaos match!
Is that really an insult? I mean, are you happy?
She called me, I'm sexy.
I know, right? Exactly. I mean, he called you Toad, right? Toad's a chode, so that makes sense. And then
that's what
I'm the big evil guy. I mean, the only other thing, like Bowser Jr., I don't know.
I mean, you can cause destruction. I mean,
so does that make Cody Powers King Boo?
Oh, thank you.
Just hold the back. We said this 20 times.
Thank you. Mine didn't have that problem. I'm so glad you guys made a worthless award to give me to make me feel happy, because participation, woo.
Soccer moms are loving it.
Exactly. You know what I mean. So whoever made this category, fuck you.
All right.
Hey!
Well, the executive producer Mario said we can't air that segment.
Exactly.
Yup. Yup, he did.
Yep.
Sure thing.
Yep. Coming up next, we have Tommy Gunn coming up to present match 5 of our Hall of Fame matches.
Why don't you switch with me? Because I got kind of taking over.
Well, 8 minute Hall of Fame speech.
You're going to see the back of my head in the camera.
Not the mullet.
All right. Right now I'm going to present the final match that will be inducted into the Hall of Fame this year. And the man receiving this award has to come up, because if he didn't come up, Matt Thunder would be up here the whole time, and nobody wants that. So, the fifth and final match is Jack Delta and Matt Thunder's 3 Stages of Hell match from Revolution, and accepting, please welcome Jack Delta once again.
See, when I found out about this one, I thought it was a little cheap that 3 matches in a row of mine got into the Hall of Fame. But every single time me and Matt Thunder go out there and do stuff, it's magic. And I hope that you guys go back and rewatch that match, and you go back and rewatch the other two, and just appreciate MEBW. Thank you.
Well, that was great. All right, this is the moment that we have all been waiting for. It's time. Chad didn't take band. It is time to announce the Wrestler of the Year. Guys, About two segments ago, I tallied all the votes to get a grand total. And I am very pleased to announce that this year, we received 122 votes for Wrestler of the Year.
All of them are Blue Piper.
Nope. I want to personally thank everyone who voted. Because, holy crap, there were so many. I remember that day when they first started coming in, and we were tallying them, and it didn't stop. Everyone was freaking out. It was like 12 hours of just nonstop. Okay, gotta change it again. Here we go. To post a minute and a half video on a Friday with no warning and get over 100 comments in like a day is super awesome. So thanks to everyone who voted. And it's time to announce the winner. Drum roll, please. For the third year in a row, Matt Thunder.
Wait, why does it say co-wrestler right here?
Oh, do you want to say it or do I want to say it?
I don't know what this is.
Well.
What the hell?
We have a tie, ladies and gentlemen. We have a full even tie. And the co-wrestlers of the year are Matt Thunder and Jack Delta.
Yes, let's go.
Challenge the king.
Let's get to it. Other side.
Other side.
Yep.
Teaching him how to take pictures.
Rogue Four. Rogue Four is dead.
You want to do co-speeches or you want to do a whole speech? No. Three times?
You guys talk at the same time.
All right, ready? So, for the third year in a row, I won.
And for the first,
I did.
Yeah.
Please shop at Kohl's. All right.
I will win for the next 20 years, too.
Thank you.
Really quickly, want to give a special shout out to the fucking Viper Maniacs, because this is Blake's first year in the fucking poll, and he got like 30 votes. It was crazy. I'm really super proud of you, too. And now, the time has come. I'm gonna pull up my speech.
Speech.
Okay. The time has come to induct Tyler Adams, by God, into the Hall of Fame.
Oh my God.
I feel I would not do this ceremony justice if I did not begin with this quote from a mutual friend of myself and Adam. Sex, drugs, and wrestling, motherfucker.
Woohoo!
JT.
JT, know where to live.
Friends, co-workers, brothers, MEBW roster. These are all words I can use to describe the group of men sitting here today. However, the one person I associate the word brother or brother with the most is our 2020 Hall of Fame inductee, Tyler Adams. From the beginning, he and I were intertwined in the world of backyard wrestling. We all know stubborn Tyler Adams. Trust me, I was his biggest foe. We had a lot of disagreements. Like at the first EBW taping in March of 2017, where Double A, God bless him, tried to do a Joker driver through a table on TV. Before the match, Adam agreed. Mid-match, he backed out, like a normal person would. Being inexperienced, and also Anthony Austin, there was a cut, because he didn't know how to cover it and go to something else. And I tore Adam a new asshole. I believe my exact words were, quote, "Don't commit to something and then not do it." And I definitely called him a bitch. Rule number one, never attack Adam's manhood. Fortunately, now I can greet him by saying, "What's up, you big bitch?" And he doesn't really care. We all remember the phases of Tyler Adams. Whether it be piece of paper with like 50 moves on it, and that's now my moveset, Tyler Adams. Or painted face, 21 Pilots obsessed Tyler Adams, or everyone's least favorite, Santino Bros Tyler Adams. I hate to burst your bubble, guys, but Adam, they weren't fans. And now, he's become very serious about his pursuit of wrestling. And it shows in how he plans and discusses the matches that he performs in. Or when he shows people techniques. The new moniker that was bestowed upon him by the Jersey Boys and the group on that podcast has been Instructor Badums. Why do I tell you all these things? Well, because there are so many quirks to our good friend Tyler Adams. We remember that jobber from Virginia. I forget that name. Apparently Fortnite knows now.
Oh.
We remember how I introduced him to Sid. You're welcome. And we remember all these things because Adam is truly the most unique person and worker that I've ever seen. He went from being a hardcore spot monkey, zero confidence, timid, shy, babyface with no charisma and a questionable gimmick, sorry, to one of the best pure workers in the backyard. His combination of mid-match charisma, savagery on the microphone, physicality and pure striking ability make him truly unique. And truthfully, it's been a complete 180. He's a founding member of this company, and he is, without a shadow of a doubt, the biggest success this company has seen in shaping a competitor up until this point. I love Adam. Without him, I wouldn't be standing here right now. I wouldn't be working for this company I so dearly love, and frankly, none of us would be here. We would not have had the successes we have seen without his help. He's old reliable. He's the epitome of a big match wrestler. Yes, he's different. The good brother may be obsessed with his business, and he may be so committed that it makes him crazy once in a while, but goddamn, he is the best of the best. No one deserves four world titles more. No one has given more to the company in the ring over the last 3 years. No one deserves to be in the Hall of Fame more than my friend and my brother. So everyone, please join me in welcoming the newest member of the MEBW Hall of Fame, four-time world champion, two-time All-American champion, first-ever internet champion, three-time tag team champion, 2018 Backyard Rumble winner, three Hall of Fame matches, and of course, my dear friend, Tyler Adams.
Well, I'm kind of embarrassed now. Reason is because that was such a well-written speech, and I didn't write anything, so I guess that's the end of the ceremony.
Speech!
Or I can just speak on what I know and what's happened to me with not only my love of backyard wrestling, but my love of wrestling before that, and I don't think a lot of you know what got me into loving wrestling, how young I got into it, and I figured now is the time to ramble on about that. So, if you've ever had parents who work till 5 o'clock and nobody can pick you up from school, you know maybe of a little program called Latchkey. So I'm in Latchkey and I am 5 years old, terrified of almost everybody in this school. And Latchkey is composed of a bunch of different people. They don't group everybody. They don't group the little kids over here and the big kids over here. Everybody just kind of hangs out and does what they want for a couple hours. Or you watch movies on Friday. And I saw two kids playing with wrestlers, and I was like, okay, that seems to be the only toys being played with in the room right now. Everybody else is just doing their own little thing. And it caught my eye because all these wrestlers that I saw were different. There was a short guy with a mask. You might have heard of him. His name's Rey Mysterio. But then there was this big guy, and he had like one strap over him, and that was the Big Show. And I was like, okay, so these guys are playing with these. Whatever. I go over there and I play with them. We play wrestlers and everything like that. And then I go home and I ask my mom to get me some toy wrestlers because, you know, I gotta be like these kids at Latchkey because I'm gonna be seeing them every day. And she gets me Christian Cage and the Six Sides of Steel TNA ring when all I wanted was a simple WWE wrestler. Thank you, Hunt, for giving me that. And I wonder if he's still on the roof of Searsma, because it was a day I was out there and I was throwing my wrestlers around. And Christian Cage ended up on top of the school. And that was the last I ever saw my first wrestler. And now, if you've ever been to my house, you know that I have over 100. So we really added to that collection over the years. And as it went, I started to do my history. I started to understand professional wrestling as it was, and quickly that became my first love in life. And it's only so long that you can keep loving this and watching this until you want to do it. And me, having a little brother, of course, we're going to hit each other with pillows, and those pillows are steel chairs, for you people who did not know that. They are steel chairs.
Word.
And so I got my little brother into it, and my peak time of loving wrestling was about, it was 2008, 2009, and my favorite wrestler became Jeff Hardy. Yes. Jeff Hardy wowed me with how different he was from everybody, how he didn't have to be sizable up to everyone else, and that made me think of myself, because I've been short all my life, and nothing's changed. So, thank you. So I really started to love that time in wrestling, and that's when you get into seeing all the greats. You get to see Undertaker and Triple H and Jeff Hardy, and back then, they all wrestled on a weekly program. None of them were part-time. They were all in the shape of their lives, and that's what made me love wrestling. So if you've been around that time, or you know anything about that time in wrestling, there's a lot of story involved. And so I got interested into the storytelling element of wrestling, as well as the moves and everything like that. And it's only so long that you can keep throwing pillows at your brother until he doesn't want to do this anymore either. So that is how Tyler Adams and Backyard Wrestling became intertwined. And you talked about him in your speech. We have to thank AA Anthony Austin.
Middle space.
Yeah. So I was in math class in ninth grade, and here is AA Anthony Austin, who's a year older than me, held back. And he will give you clear indications on why he was held back in that math class by the fact that I look over and he's watching the WWE Network. And I'm like, okay, so there are some people in high school who still give a shit about professional wrestling. That's pretty cool. And I walk over to him, and we're both watching the WWE Network every day in class. And then it turns into, do you want to come over and wrestle? And we start watching wrestling. We both find our interest in old wrestlers. We find our interest in hardcore wrestling. And we get into the scary part of my story. So there are a couple matches that I will admit to you people that you will never see that I almost died in. And that is real. I was about this close to death because of the amount of pain that was happening so quickly. When you don't know how to sequence a match, everything just happens quickly. And you start smacking each other with 100 light tubes and dropping each other on thumbtacks.
Yeah.
That was my rough way of getting into backyard wrestling. And I remembered that we were wrestling for people who weren't wrestling fans. So it's not like we were wrestling for a big YouTube channel where thousands of people wanted to see this. We were wrestling for neighborhood kids. We were wrestling for a couple of my friends who didn't really give a shit about wrestling. And the main thing we looked at is, well, how are we going to take a bunch of non-wrestling fans and get them to sit down and surround us while we do all this crazy shit for at least 20 minutes? And the way it was, me and AA discovered a professional wrestling company called CZW. You know anything about CZW? The light tubes are the least of your worries in CZW, as you might also get a needle put through your cheek. I know that John Moxley, Dean Ambrose, however you want to address him, has a slit in his neck, and there's a scar there, and it's from something he did in CZW where his neck had an opening. Oh. Kind of close to the opening that I had on my side when me and AA had something called the Ultraviolent Bloodfest.
Uh-oh.
After this, I will move on from all that stuff, because that is the most memorable one to me. That is the one where I came probably the closest to death. And you were there. Thank you for reffing that match.
Emotionally scarred.
Thank you for reffing that match and not doing a referee's job and ensuring our safety, because there was no safety. And that's not your fault, by the way. So, we had that match. I had light tubes broken over me. Most of the light tubes went to me, and AA could never put me over for the life of him. So, he won that match, and most of the light tubes went into my back. And that's why I have scarring there that I am going to carry around with me for the rest of my life. He poured salt on it. We did thumbtacks, flaming table.
God, about the salt!
Yeah, that...
Almost did the flaming table, but God said no, put some wind down there.
Yes, so thank you, God, for that one. And then Anthony and I are going through high school, and it's like, okay, we found each other, but is there anyone else who potentially likes wrestling this much? And we call upon an old elementary school friend of mine, Tommy Gunn.
Ciao.
And that is how EBW is born. EBW had a very short run until we all of a sudden were exposed to HWW. And, you know, we're going to kiss each other's ass a little bit. We're going to have a match over there. They're going to have a match over here. And we're going to work together a little bit. And that is how MEBW was born. And so it starts with the roots of those companies. It starts with people like me and Anthony over in one corner. It starts with people like Tommy Gunn and JT over in another corner. And then it has Matt Thunder and Chris Storm. Everybody has their stars. And now we have room for a star-studded lineup of absolutely incredible wrestlers to deliver you people what you're getting now. And then you know, you guys know the rest. It's the MEBW history that you can look at forever now. And I do remember the terrible, terrible, awful gimmicks that you so greatly explained in your speech, where I painted
Rich
my
Tyler
face.
Adams.
Yeah, painted my face, wrote down 50 moves because I thought if I got 50 moves, these people are gonna love me. And in EBW, that's pretty much how they love me. And then you figure out as you're going and as you're learning that there's more than that. There's more than having 50 moves. There's more to storytelling, and there's more to the actual wrestling of a match than just doing all these different moves. And so when it was time to buckle down and get serious, I didn't know where my backyard career was headed. I could not get that face paint gimmick over anymore, and all you people fell in love with Chris Storm. More than I've ever seen somebody fall in love with a wrestler. You guys loved Chris Storm. And I was like, well, wait a minute, that's my spot. That's my spot in the company. I'm supposed to have a top spot too. This is what I worked so hard for. And that's when I knew it was time for a change. That's when I knew it was time to start telling more of a story than painting my face and making it look shitty almost half the time due to rain, sweat, or just my ability to not use Crayola paint markers from the store. So it became time to buckle down, and I had to find something quick, because wrestling, whether it's professional wrestling or backyard wrestling, I've learned that wrestling will move on from you quicker than you think it will. So I had to adjust. There was no other options on the table, and being a babyface just did not fit me anymore. And I've started to morph myself into what you guys see now. And I've started to understand wrestling more as I've gone with backyard wrestling. And I love this. And so to be inducted into the Hall of Fame now, knowing everything that I came from, knowing where I started from, and knowing where I've ended up now, I could not be more grateful. Thank you, guys.
Here, bring the camera up here a little bit. All right, it's time to present Tyler Badhams with his Hall of Fame ring, and it's off the fucking holder. I wonder who did that.
Yeah, I wonder. Shop WWE.
Probably the metrosexual in the fucking pineapple shirt.
Matt Thunder?
Matt Thunder? Come on.
All right, here, bring it up here.
Get on your knee.
I don't want him to see it yet.
It's different.
It's a WWE replica.
Wow. You were the last grand champion, so they thought it would be fucking a pop. Here you go, dude.
That is a pop. All right.
Fuck yeah.
Avengers Assemble.
Hall of Fame.
JT, you're here in spirit.
JT, yeah. JT's doing some electrical.
I'll take a spot.
JT did it like.
All right, yeah. Now we got the shield.
Marks. All right, thanks everybody for watching. Please tune in to Backyard Mania tomorrow live. We put a lot of work into it, as always. And we hope you watch it. And we got some announcements. We got some matches. We got a bunch of crazy shit. So, we'll see you guys tomorrow night.
Woo!
We are the champions. believe it.
Oh, yo, when the tights were fresh.
I remember that.
Off hardcore?
Yeah.
Did you see how did I send you my back after that kendo stick?
No, Aaron, you might have. Oh.
That thud was fucking creepy. Yo, I love that smoke machine. Damn, that was pretty fucking good. Remember when Anthony wanted to do like two table spots every week on TV?
Yes.
Hey,
Undertaker.
That was it. That was the segment. It was 90 degrees that day. We wore the suit for 1 second. Never wore it again. Oh, my ass is in that one.
All along.
That was a headlock, Matt.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Didn't you guys just go into headlocks the whole room?
Yes. All for Chris Storm.
Oh, Hunter Jones making his way.
Everyone always thinks he's coming back. Yeah. They're like, he's coming out of the
ring. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, the classic.
Oh, wasn't that Royal Rumble?
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I would have picked up a bimbo from Woody.
Oh,
Tommy,
there went your head.
No.
Mark.
Oh, yeah.
Shit.
Eat it, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, oh, yeah. Dude, did you back your nuts on that?
Oh, yeah, 2025 was fucking out.
No.
Yeah. You know now what it's like to win that world title.
Here?
But you have no idea what it's like to win.
I recognize that song somewhere.
Oh, the
HWW debut.
Oh yeah, don't even wait for the beat to drop, just fucking expose yourself, Tyler. Hell yeah.
Yeah, you're out about 30 seconds early there, sir.
Yeah, yeah. I don't even remember whose house was this.
I know what
that match guy in there. I don't know who the hell sent crazy all that footage.
Take a hot guess.
Small package driver, yeah. Well, it's not gonna take many.
Oh, that was
ugly. He's in the ultraviolet.
Never again.
Yeah, never again.
Why did Joe Dean's entrance just get
that? That might be one of my favorite
songs. That's so awesome. Dude, I just want to put that out. Put this out there. Best double flip stomp in backyard wrestling I've ever seen.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Crazy Al.
That's fucking awesome.
Thank you.
You're on camera.